Hey guys, welcome back to the next episode of the Jaguars Rebuild. We are in week 5, where we will be at home to the 2-2 Tennessee Titans and facing the beast that is Derrick Henry. I don't know what you can use to describe that man. I mean, he's 6'4", 250 pounds, and he runs like a wrecking ball with the speed of a train. So it's going to be a difficult week this week. Not sure how we're going to stop him. We're going to have to sell out to stop the run and make Ryan Tannehill throw some picks. Player returning from injury, we've got Jawan Taylor returning, which is good. That will bolster our offensive line. Do want to check out, actually, we are close to, I'm sure we're close to finding out Trevor Lawrence's dev trait. Now, if it's not a superstar, considering he's a number one overall pick, I'm going to be a little bit disappointed. Got a little ways to go. Hopefully find that out before the bye week, but it'll probably be the game after the bye week. But hopefully he'll be he's got to be a star, worst case. Superstar would be amazing. But there's nothing else really to do now. We've done everything, so we'll move into the game. So here comes Trevor Lawrence, and the offense need to score first, need to get a touchdown first. And no, we're going to get picked straight off and give them the ball on the 14-yard line. Oh, happy days. This is a good start. He's 4 touchdowns and 2 picks is Ryan Tannehill. And that's because they run everything. And that's all that's really going to happen here, let's be honest. So we get a stop there for a 3-yard gain, as he rushed for 105 yards and a touchdown off 27 carries last week. We're going to have to go man a lot this week so that we can focus on taking Derrick Henry out. But that's a touchdown already. Okay then. It's down 7-0 after 3 plays, really. 1 by us, which was a pick, and 2 by Tennessee. All right, let's try and clear that first drive out of the way, and now we've got the we don't know what play we've called problem. And I should have followed that round the outside. I didn't fancy throwing deep, certainly not straight away, but as Dan Arnold gets us a first down. I mean, he says Trevor Lawrence is 1-2. He's 2-2, to be fair. He's thrown 2 passes. He's been caught twice. So I'm going to say he's perfect on the day so far. But 15-yard gain. And Etienne are getting stopped after 4 for a 2nd and 6. I mean, trying to run on a defense that practices against Derrick Henry isn't going to lead to too much success, but we can't just throw the ball. Can't just throw the ball around with abandon. So no, thrown it to the wrong man. Please don't. He's had it bounced off of everybody and bits. It's bounced off of a guy's head, a guy's back, and into the defender's hands. And it was a bad pass. Right from the word go, it was a bad pass. I knew the moment I threw it. It was a stupid pass to throw, but he was under pressure. I knew it was a bad throw, obviously, but I didn't expect this, where it bounces off his hand, then off of his mate's shoulder and straight into his hands. There we go. So we got a bit of luck last week. We've got none coming this week. And there's a pick. Wingard with a pick. Get a block. Why are you just standing there, 44? Get a block. But we got a pick. Wingard, come on. What was that? Derrick Henry they sent up for the catch. I didn't know what coverage I was in because that's one of the abilities that the team's got, but he sends him up for the catch. Big play by 44 to knock it out of his hands, and Wingard is right in there, but he's too busy celebrating to block AJ Brown. Where if he blocks AJ Brown instead of celebrating, who is 44? Miles Jack. If you were blocking instead of celebrating, Wingard has a touchdown. That's a little bit disappointing that we had a touchdown if Miles Jack just, you know, actually tried to block instead of celebrate. But got a first down there with DJ. I need to try and get rid of their momentum, to get rid of the fact that I can't see the play call that I'm playing, and I can't see the buttons. See if I can audible to a run, because I'd like my chances against the front line like that. Get six, second and four, and we'll get the ball back to ETN. See if he can get... Oh, close to a first down, but it's going to be third and inches. Third and inches. I mean, if they stop us fourth and inches, I'm going for it with a QB sneak. But they're not. And Robinson was right up the middle and had a lane that closed very quickly out of nowhere. And the run game is what's going to keep us moving. So we're just going to pound the rock. And Chenault got off his block a little bit too early. We get 2 yards from that run. We're going to run it again. And that didn't work out, as 58. Landry the third was able to get right round and take those 2 yards back. So it's now a third and 10. Need to try and convert this. At least get close to it. No, they batted it down. And a fourth and 10 from their 32. I don't think we can risk a fourth and 10. 7 mile an hour wind. I'm not sure I gave it enough power there. Please just creep over. Just crept over. 7-3, and I'm disappointed with Miles Jack for celebrating instead of blocking. Could have been 7-7, but those clouds look minging. They look dark. But we've got a 7-3. We've got a takeaway. We haven't had one of those for a while. I've left Julio all alone. That's on me, leaving Julio all alone. Can't leave Julio Jones wide open like that. Oh. Miles Jack and 45. I can't remember his name. Make him stop for a second and two. As once again, I've completely bought the play action. And that's a first down with Derrick Henry. And a QB spy with Miles Jack. And Derrick Henry's off to the races, but Jenkins with a big tackle, taking him out at the legs there. But with where they are now on the field, we need to hold them to a field goal. Bounces off, but steps out of bounds. There was enough contact there to step, force him out. And we're now second and five. Going to cover the goal line with Wingard. There's a big stop. Number 91, Smoot, sends them backwards, and it's now third and six. Let's see if we can get a big stop here. Stop them on the line. It's fourth and one. But they're going to go for it. Don't blame them. They do have Derrick Henry there. They stopped it. No, he's dragged him over. Had to stop. Derrick Henry comes out for number seven. It's now second and goal. And Derrick Henry's back in. Stop him, stop him, stop him. Stop him down on the 1 yard line for a third and goal. This is a big one. They're probably going to go for it. As I would if I've got Derrick Henry in the backfield. Stopped him back. Fourth and two. Sorry, fourth and goal from the 3 yard line. We stopped. Stopped them. Sent them 2 yards backwards. And they're settling for a field goal. This is big because with Derrick Henry, I'm going for it. Now, that's probably why I'm losing. But with Derrick Henry, you've got to go for it. From the 3 yard line, surely you just line everybody up and you go, we're just going to pound this through. But no, they kick a field goal, which is good for us because now we're only down by a touchdown. Down by a touchdown at the end of the first. And he breaks it to the outside where he's got loads of space. Cuts it in. He's juked the defender. He's running upfield. That's a huge first down as he gets it to the 45-yard line in Titans territory. James Robinson with the big gains. As Chenault gets that and gets a first down from it. That's 39 yards passing for Trevor Lawrence. And Dan Arnold with the first down. Sorry when I got a bit quiet there, got a little bit. Getting a little bit tense here. Might be able to tie a game up, which will make a change. Well, we've got Robinson back in the backfield as we go for a run. And we're going to cut it up into the middle. And we get caught, but we got a gain of three. So second and seven. And there's no reason to get away from this. We're going to go back to the run. We're going to line up jumbo, I formation. I'm going to hand it back to Robinson. And we're just going to charge it up the middle. And we get caught at the line. managed to roll forwards for a couple. My third and three now. Need to find a good third and three play as we're down on the 14th. On the 14 yard line. Dan Arnold catches it. He's in for the touchdown, diving touchdown. Dan Arnold with the spike, tying the game up. And we celebrate. Here comes the defense, who should be buoyed by what the offense has just done. Ah, run up the wrong side, but we've stopped Derrick Henry anyway for about six, I would say. Yeah, six it is. So second and four. Oh, he's missed him. He's breaking off a big run there, Derrick Henry. If he could have just bowled one guy over, he had the end zone. Herndon's in the on the field. Oh, big tackle from 95 there. Man with a big name. Robertson Harris, that's it. Robertson Harris with the big stop of Derrick Henry for no gain. It's a second and 10. Miles Jack helping defend. He just had too much time. You can't defend, you can't cover for that long, and they get a huge, huge gain there. And now try and stop. Now and try and stop them again, holding them to just a field goal. Is they going to run this ball? That's the first down, and it's first and goal from the 6 yard line. And we're back to just doing everything we can to stop this juggernaut in the backfield. And we can't. He's in. Touchdown. So it's 17-10 now, with 5:27 to go. And because of the momentum that the Titans have, I can't see the right plays that I'm calling, so I don't know who I'm thrown to or where I'm thrown to them, which is going to make this drive difficult. But we're going to look to run the clock, score a tie-in touchdown, big hit from 54 to stop it on third and inches. They're going to blitz if I run this. But I'm going to run anyway. I trust him. I trust Robinson. And with that trust, he gets me that first down. He's averaging 5 yards a carry. And I'm going to have to focus in on one person. I think I'll have to focus in on Chenault Jr. here to try and complete this. He's straight off. 74 got beat. 25 didn't even see him coming, and Landry comes straight in with a big sack. I just didn't have a chance. I had no time to even look down the field. And he's picked. I'm trying to fit it in. No confidence in that O-line, and the pass goes too early. It's easily picked, and the impressive start is starting to unravel. And that's his second pick of the game. But a nice stop there from the defense. I don't know who's doing what on this play. And that's Julio Jones wide open for the easy six. And that's 24-10. There's Dan Arnold with the catch and a first down. Thrown 10 times for 76 yards, only completed 6 and 2 picks. This is and Trevor Lawrence is going to run it. Tried to get him to slide, but too late. He gets an 11-yard rush and a first down. I'd rather he didn't take those sort of hits, but when you're losing like this and you're back in the game, you do whatever you can. As we've got 4 seconds until the half. Inaccurate. He was wide open. He had his feet set. And he just can't make that pass. And that isn't good enough from a number one overall pick. We need him to make those passes. And it's now 2nd and 10, under 2 minutes to go. It's DJ Chark. Nah, he's picked. DJ Chark didn't even try and catch it. And Janoris Jenkins has picked him. And this is a big crash down to earth after the half-decent Bengals game and the good first quarter, the promising first quarter. We've unraveled big time here. But we got to make a stop, make them punt. And that's not going to happen. There's the first down. Oh, it's just... Keep the defender out the shoes for another first down. So I've got Wingard on Jones. That's going to go well. There's a stop. 2nd and 8. That's just what I'm going to have to do. I'm just going to have to go man. Tannehill, no one to throw to, and that's 3rd and 8. So we've got Jenkins in deep zone with Wingard. Being outrun. Tight ends outrunning our defenders, that's not good. That's their third timeout, 20 seconds to go. As long as they just don't complete, don't get out of bounds. He's picked, but picked out of bounds. Tyson, what's his name? Tyson Campbell, that's it. Tyson Campbell intercepting the ball, but out of bounds. And that's a tackle, and that'll be it for the first half. Oh no, they're going to go for it. And there's he had Julio Jones wide open. He had the touchdown. He had Julio Jones wide open there. There. Straight off. Just straight over the top. And you've got a touchdown. Still got it. Still got it. And he throws it underneath to the tight end. Now, I'm not going to complain about Ryan Tannehill being rubbish and picking the tight end over Julio Jones in wide open space and nobody 10 yards close to him as everybody's behind. I'm not going to complain about that as we stop them on their 14. But my God, He was wide open. Now we've got to go again, trying to stop this offense, which isn't easy. This O-line of theirs seems to be able to do whatever it pleases. Shaquille Griffin's got Julio Jones. I'm going to have to take that one just in case. And he's dropped it. The tight end has dropped it. It's 3rd and 3. Let's run. Stop. And it's going to be 4th and 1. As Derrick Henry's up to 111 yards. And they're going to punt it away. Here we go, trying to get something going as we are still well within this game. Ah, trying to turn it up. He gets stopped for 2nd and 10. And Lawrence is so inaccurate. It's absolutely driving me crazy. He's so inaccurate. But Chenault gets his feet down with the toe drag swag there. With a shout out to Burleson for that one. He loves his toe drag swags on game day football whenever. Well, as he's not on there anymore, but I throw that away, nothing there. We need to get a touchdown here. I think I might go no huddle, lineman can't block. So it's 3rd and 10. And I've walked myself into sack. Walked myself into that, and it's 4th and 22, and we're punting. And missed up opportunity with that punt. Five, four with the stop. It's 2nd and 9 as Wilson does a swag walk after making a tackle on with a 1 yard gain on it. And there's another one. Gotsis with the tackle for a 1 yard gain, and it's now 3rd and 8. We look to make a big stop here on 3rd and 8. And we've failed. And the tight end just shrugs Miles Jack away as if he's a nobody. And it's 1st and 10. So we're going to chuck some. More blitz in. As Henry's up to 120 in the third. Don't know what you're doing there, fella. Run to the outside of Derrick Henry for a 2 yard gain, and it's 3rd and 1. And we'll just chuck in another blitz. We don't really have any option as Tyson Campbell's on Julio Jones. And he rolls forward for a 2 yard gain and a 1st down. Big 3rd and 7 here. I had two of them. I had Brown and I had Jones. Who do you cover there when you're on your own? Brown or Jones. I mean, come on. And they're just eating clock. I need to try and get a forced fumble or something. Forced fumble, pick, something. I need the defense to do something here to stop them from going 27-10 up. To really give us... to really give us a chance at winning this game, because I do believe we're still in it. I do. I'd rather be 14 down than 17, no. Second and 10. And Tyson Campbell's on Julio Jones again, so I'll have to follow him, because I don't trust the defense. Look, tackle him, tackle him, tackle him. Jenkins comes up and tackles Henry. That's third and 7. Oh, he had the pick. Tyson Campbell had it. Go. 27-10 down by 3 scores. Trevor Lawrence steps up. And we need to get something going, as nearly got the first down there, but it's second and 2. We look to get the first down here, and we'll just pound the rock with James Robinson. And there it is, only a 2-yard gain, but that's all we needed. It's first and 10, and no running, just runs the clock down, and we need the ball. We need to score quickly, but I can't just throw the ball. I don't know what play, I don't know who to. Lines all over the place. Ryan Tannehill's trying to G up his team. Not that he needs to, because... well, we're up by 3, but here we go. We'll take a stretch to the outside. A burst, but can't get away from 48. Just not quick enough. And now it's 3rd and 8, and we are going to have to throw the ball. Big 3rd down here. And Lawrence can't be accurate. We're not able to do anything this game. This is all on Trevor Lawrence, his inability to be accurate when there's no pressure in his face is a huge problem. He hits that, it's a first down. We're moving the ball. But there he is, getting cold feet or whatever, jittery, and he's overthrowing the receiver, and it's a turnover. We've got to punt the ball away. We had the chance, and there's a huge stop. Second and 13 now. Over the 3-yard loss. Derrick Henry's breathing heavy, and I'm not surprised, he's had a huge workload today. But that's about 3rd and 7. Need to try and stop this. Why?
It's now appearing that this losing streak is going to continue. You know, the coaching staff was confident that this was going to be the game to stem the tide, but that just has not been the case.
Oh, he couldn't catch it. He's dropped it, and it's second and 10. and the first time that Trevor Lawrence has been able to be accurate for any sort of period of time. And the tight end can't catch it. And Chenault is able to pull that in, and it's a first down. Trevor Lawrence is able to complete a pass. And Dan Arnold can't catch again. I finally get Trevor Lawrence being accurate, and now my players are deciding to have bricks for hands.
To throw again on second down, Lawrence escaping the pressure right.
He's not catching that one. He's not even trying. He didn't even go up to catch that one. That's... that's disappointing. No, why am I throwing that way? How is a man the size of 93 there able to keep up Trevor Lawrence on the run? I don't know. I don't know. I know we got to go for it, but I don't know. I'm not sure what. No, should have been picked. 8 of 22. And at least 3 of them were on the receiver. Oh. Straight up the middle. And nowhere near the running back. This one's a little bit disheartening, gotta be honest. Miles Jack straight up with a big tackle. Yeah, a little bit disheartened with this one. We had every opportunity. Oh, I can't even intercept it. We had every opportunity to really win this game. I do believe we were well within a shout to win this one. I hasn't extended it. But through inaccuracies from Trevor Lawrence, unnecessary inaccuracies as well, and just some drops from receivers, hasn't helped. No, pick. Oh, pick six. How is my guy just batting it down in their end zone, in the end zone, with a free play on the ball, but he's picking a challenge ball off. And it's 41-10. And the score doesn't do it justice, I'll be honest. This isn't a 41-10 game. Tennessee don't deserve 41 points. I do believe Jacksonville deserve more than 10. But you can't do that with the level of play. I mean, look at that. You just let a man run through unblocked on a return. You can't do that. And that's what's caused this game. That's what's caused us to be so poor today, is that sort of thing. Catch, first down. Oh, and he slipped one block. One tackle. So first and 10. We're not going to give up. We're going to try and score. Flushed out right. And as he tries to slide, he gets hit. But it's a first and 10 now. At least Trevor Lawrence hasn't given up. The offense hasn't given up. That's important. There's Robinson. Oh, trucks two players there. Big truck from Robinson to get another first down. Can't find his tight end 3 yards, well, 5 yards away from him. That's what's hindered us. That's what has stopped us from being within a win there. Is Trevor Lawrence not being able to be accurate on those short throws? We said the short throws was what we needed to win this game, and he hasn't been able to complete any of them, or many of them, or he just doesn't like Dan Arnold. I don't know. I don't know if it's because he doesn't like Arnold, but he doesn't seem to want to throw to him. And that was nearly a sixth pick. And he's found Robinson for a big game. And gets his first and goal from the 8 yard line. And everybody's coming and I'll throw the ball away, and he gets sacked. Apparently he's not allowed to throw the ball away. He has to be sacked because I'm not allowed to score a touchdown. And that is not me being salty or complaining. It's me complaining. But I'd pushed the throwaway button. He starts the animation and then just pulls the ball back down so he can be sacked. So we get 11 out of that. And it's now third and goal from the 11-yard line. And I don't know why we're going to kick the field goal. I suppose it's just for the sake of getting points, really. Because it doesn't do anything for us. And there it is. Field goal. 41-13. It's another loss. We're 0-4. Last two games, I felt good about them. I have felt good about them. But this one was more disappointing than the Bengals game, just because of this 13 off of 31 attempts and 186 yards. The five picks didn't help, but there was so much more than just that going on. We had 15 attempts and 58 rushing yards from Robinson, 29 yards off of 6, and Trevor Lawrence got 21 off of the 2 rushing attempts for him. Chenault had 93 yards off of 6 receptions. Dan Arnold had 52 off of 4, should have had at least 6 catches, but inexplicably dropped them for whatever reason. Could have had a hell of a lot more if he didn't drop them and Trevor could be accurate. James Robinson had 2 for 30. Chark 1 reception for DJ, which went for 11 yards. Not much else. Wingard had 10 tackles. with one interception. Miles Jack had 13 tackles. Damian Wilson had 13 tackles, two for losses. Trey Herndon had 5. Robertson Harris, 4. Jenkins, 7. Tyson Campbell, 4. Shaquille Griffin had 6. But not much else really going on there. So we're 0-5 after probably the most disappointing loss, which is crazy to say considering we lost 70, or we conceded 70 points, 70-21 I think it was. But last two games have been exactly the same, 41-13. But the Tennessee game was the most disappointing just because of, I think that was easily the most winnable game we've played so far this season. And we're at the Tottenham Hotspur Stadium, so we're playing in London this week. 0-5 going up against the 2-3 Miami Dolphins. So yeah, there's not really anything else to do now apart from thank you all for watching. Sincerely hope you enjoy it. I'm enjoying this series, so I do hope that's coming across to you guys and you guys are enjoying it as well. That's really all I'm doing this for. As much as I want to win, the wins are secondary to making an enjoyable and entertaining channel and series. So yeah, I'm conveying how much I'm enjoying this, and I hope you guys are enjoying it. Please again, like the channel, like the video, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you know when the next episodes are loaded up, and I will see you next time when we play the 2-3 Miami Dolphins in London.